meaning product or object. I repeat, to convert the ideas, creating some engineering product or object into some real product or object. I have some idea. Okay. I have some idea. I have some product, but that can't explain by me with the help of proper terms. So on that time, what I can do, I just draw in that way, which can easily understand by anybody. Okay. Which can easily understand by anybody. As I explained you earlier that if you are visited at some sites of civil where engineer have some drawing in their hand. On that time, what they are doing, they have, based on that drawing, they can prepare
सर साउंड नहीं आवतो
सर अवाज नहीं आवतो
सर तमारो माइक बंद छे
ओके ऑडिबल
सर
यस सर
ओके जस्ट वन मिनट
यस सर
Yeah. Okay. So, in one word, we can say that suppose we have any idea and which can't be explained properly with the help of explanation, then we are just drawing it and we understand, we explain to the opposition or to the customer or to the anybody with the help of some drawing. Okay. So, it is one kind of engineering language. So, to creating some engineering product or object into some real product or object, the engineer has to communicate with others. It is impossible to express the ideas using some common language. Okay, so every time I have to talk to the student who are from outside of the India, I have to talk with the student who are from the Bangalore, I have to talk with the student who are from the Delhi. I want to talk with the student who are from the Pakistan or the India.
I think PPT is not visible. Okay. So when I have to talk with many students or many colleagues, or we can say with the others whose language may be Gujarati, maybe English, maybe Urdu, maybe Bengali, maybe we don't know. Okay, so on that time, what we have to do? Either we have to learn each and every language so it's easy for us to communicate, which is impossible. Okay, suppose I am at France, or I am at USA, or I am at Australia. So on that time, every time it is not necessary that the language which known by the others, which also understand by us. So on that time, there is one common thing that we may proceed for that. That is called as a engineering language, or we can say that drawing is the very, very easiest way to understand anybody what we want to say, or how we can share our ideas without any query. Okay, so but on that time, what happened? There is some limitation that whosoever the opposition or whosoever the others, they may know that language. Otherwise, it's a confusion with the student or the others, or whosoever there, that probably they may be confused with or the interruption is somewhat different. So on that time, it is compulsory that each and every person know the language of the drawing. It is one kind of that's why we have considered that is the one importance of engineering language, that is engineering graphics. Okay. It is impossible to express the ideas using some common language. Okay. So engineering drawing of the product or the object can speak of all important features of it that can be understood by the entire engineering community. Okay, so we are considered that with the explanation, and without explanation, suppose I want to say something, then I just draw one drawing and do not say anything, and still it may be easily understand, then it is called as engineering. Okay, so I just show you some basic parts or basic accessories, instrument which are used in drawing. You just keep in your mind that aapko ye sab accessories or instrument you have to purchase, so that I discuss, and after that give some brief introduction which are important and common instrument that you can purchase. Okay, so and if you are in biomedical, so probably in second semester, from the second semester, you have to not use these all the instruments. So probably I just advise that you may just use, or you may purchase the instrument from your colleague also for one semester. So it may not costly for you. If you are in mechanical or civil, then it may be useful up to 8 semesters. So on that time, every time we are not beggar with somebody, and we are using. So on that time, we are say that for mechanical and civil engineering student, they may purchase the product, or they may purchase all the instrument and regarding accessories. So it may be very helpful to them up to end of the bachelor. Okay. So but you are in biomedical, and probably it may not be useful for you in next semester. So I just suggest that you may just borrow from your senior or from your colleague who may
pass the subject, and you may use in current semester and next semester. You may definitely, if pass the subject, then no need to use it in your future. So it may be used in that way. Engine drawing of the product or the object can speak of all the important feature. Okay, whatever the feature we want to add, we are just insert in the drawing. So all the characteristic, all the features of the product can easily analyze by the drawing. So drawing itself speak that what kind of properties it has, what kind of features it has, and how it may be sustained for that. So we have to not say anything, but drawing can say each and everything. It is called as a, or it is important, that kind of work, if we are considered, then it is called as a, or it is known as a engineering drawing. Now, the accuracy of its design and for further modification in it as when it required. Okay, so that is the advantage, and we are considered that requirement. Suppose you are in the first semester and you may start to learn about the subject, then you just draw this draw the drawing with proper accuracy. Accuracy means you require, or whatever we are taking right now, everything in millimeter, mm. So your dimensions regarding each and every point, regarding each and every dimension, regarding each and every parameter, you keep with proper accuracy. Okay, suppose the dimension is 10 mm, and the one rectangle you have to draw whose dimension is 10 mm length and 8 mm width. So on that time, it may be exact accurately you have to draw 10 mm length with the length and 8 mm width with the width in mm. Okay, so वहाँ पे 10 का 9 भी नहीं होना चाहिए, 11 भी नहीं होना चाहिए, and same way it may not in width 7 या 9. Okay, so that kind of accuracy we require in the drawing. Engineering drawing or graphics can be considered as the language of engineer, which has its own grammar, like any other language, in the form of definite sets of rules. Okay, there is some rules that we discuss. If you have page, or if you sit with note and pen, then I just give some list of instrument which are very important, and which we are discussing the PPT also one by one. So you note down the instrument. So in the next time, we just start with basics. So you may just know how we have to use and how to use that instrument in our daily routine. Okay, so in whole PPT, what we have to learn: visualization, the ability to mentally control visual information, graphics theory we can learn here, geometry and projection techniques that we can learn, standards, this is very important point, standards, set of rules, there are some rules that govern how parts are made and technical drawing are represented. The words you can learn here that I highlight, technical drawing are represented. Okay, there is some standard, there is some rule, most probably BIS standard we are using. So based on that, based on requirement of the standard, we prepare the drawing and we read that all the drawing. But here the word is technical. Okay, so which may be used in the our daily routine or in the industries or by the some engineer. Okay, conventions, commonly accepted practice and method used for the technical drawing, tools,
the device used to create technical drawing and models, and application, the various use of technical drawings, how drawings is important to all engineering discipline that we are learn in our this PPT. Okay. At the end, I share this whole PPT in Google Classroom every time. Okay. As I mentioned earlier, that whatever the material we are share on the Google Classroom. So after end of this lecture, I just share one code in WhatsApp group, so everybody can join with that code on and start to learn the engineering graphics and design. Okay. Now we know very well that the summation of basic and advanced, it is called as a success. Okay, when we get the success, there is basic funda here to succeed in the engineering graphics. You should know about the basics, and you have some in your mind regarding advanced. Advanced means whatever we are doing right now, in either it may be file pages or it may be in the sketchbook, but same thing or same drawing we are implement in the computer, like AutoCAD, like CAD, computer aided design, computer aided engineering, computer aided manufacturing, okay, computer integrated manufacturing. Okay, so these all are the advanced thing in the engineering graphics. Okay, so basic that we learn from today and up to end of the semester, that is basic regarding engineering graphics, and advanced also learn in the last chapter. Okay, in our syllabus, the last chapter is regarding the advanced of engineering graphics. Okay, where computer aided drawing is there, where we know that how to draw, or we understand that in computer, okay, with the help of AutoCAD, where 2D drawing is there, 3D drawing is there. In 2D drawing, how to draw line, how to draw circle or rectangle or hatch line, fillet, chamfer, trim. Okay, so these all things we can start to draw in computer. So probably there is no confusion and there is no any hesitation when probably we are start our career. Okay, so it is also important that we have to not only use the basic, but we also join, or we also start to learn the advanced thing. Okay, so basic of any subject is constant but not advanced. Okay, means what? Means ke whatever basics of any subject is may be repeated. Okay, we are you are right now in the first semester in 2020, but if same way we are considered that whosoever entering the 1996 1997 up to 2000 or up to 2019, they are same basics learn in same subject. Okay, but advance is not every time same. Okay, so advance may be differ as per the technology. Okay, we are talk about the technology right now. Recent technologies are very vast. Okay, if you are visited in any industry where we don't require the human also to do the work, in place of human, directly robots are introduced with the customer, or we are considered that without human, product can check very easily with the help of programming. Product can manufacture also. Okay, sometime what happen ki we have to cut, suppose I want to prepare the rectangle of a wooden part whose thickness is 10 mm. From that time, we have to cut with the help of hacksaw. And after that, we can After that, we can use that rectangle. Right now, recently what happened, that that cut can done with the help of hexo. This is one thing that advanced we are consider, and whatever we learn right now, that is the basic. So every time basic is same, but the advanced may be different. Based on that, your success may be defined. Okay, so without basic, we can't make extraordinary work. Okay. Sometimes we understand or we directly focus on advance, as you mentioned here, and as I mentioned here, the arrow or focus on without basic. If you haven't funda, if you haven't basic thing, then I damn sure you may not analyze, you may not perfectly understand the advanced thing, and I damn sure you may not probably get success. If you definitely if you succeed, but that success may not go up to long life. Okay, so without basic, we can't make extraordinary work. Innovation is also occur only through basic. Okay, so if you have good basic, if you have good funda, if you have good knowledge regarding basics, then innovations are there, and we probably get many example if you have the basic idea of the concerned subject. Okay, so basics are the base, as we know that whenever we have to prepare the or we have to build any building, on that time the base is very important. Same way to grow up any, the roots are very rigid. On that time, it's a result, or it may be sustained for long life. So we are considered that if your base is good, you may probably sustain for long life or more life. Okay, so I just suggest all of you, I just request to all of you that you first go through the basic, you go through the subject, and then you directly jump on the advanced. Okay. I just give some notes regarding instruments which we have to use. I just give some name. First is the drawing board. You just remember the name, what is the application and how it may be used, what kind of looks is there, that we are discussing in the next lecture. But today, I just give the brief introduction about all the instrument and accessories which is required to draw any technical drawing. Okay, the first one is the drawing board. I just showed drawing board. So yeah, mostly it may be made from the wood, smooth surface. Okay, smooth surface, and having a rectangle shape. Mostly it may be made from the seasoned soft wood. Approx thickness is 25 mm, and the drawing board is fastened at the back to prevent the warping. That you have to remember. Most probably we are used the drawing board of many sizes which are given to you. The sizes are 1000 by 1500 mm, or we have designated with help of as per the standard, as per the BIS standard. The name of the standard is 1444 1989. Okay, so these all the dimensions given to you as per the IS 1444 1989. Okay, so it may to you to give the support to your drawing. Okay, so it is mandatory part of your drawing. Next is the T square or mini drafter. It is the mini drafter. I just explain the difference here. The figure is not given to you, the T square, but figure of mini drafter is given to you. See here, the shape is this and this. If only this portion is that, it look like T. Okay, then it is called as a T square, and it include remaining accessories also. Then it is called as a mini drafter. Why it is necessary and why it require and which you have to purchase, that I can explain to you. Suppose I put my sheet at here where I want to draw. मेरे पास एक शीट है, उसमें मुझे ड्राइंग करनी है. ओके, सो वो ड्राइंग शीट में यहाँ पे रखूंगा ऑन दिस बोर्ड. राइट, नाउ वहां पे मुझे एक हॉरिजॉन्टल लाइन ड्रॉ करनी. ओके, आई वांट टू ड्रॉ द हॉरिजॉन्टल स्ट्रेट लाइन. कैसे? आइदर विद द हेल्प ऑफ मिनी ड्राफ्टर और विद द हेल्प ऑफ टी स्क्वायर. ओके, सो एंड देन also I want to draw the vertical line. So T square has some limitation that it may not draw the vertical line. So on that time, if you are not drafter, then in place of mini drafter, if you can purchase the T square, then you may purchase the set square. Okay, you may purchase the set square where 40 degree set square and 30 degree, 60 degree set square are there. Okay, so I just add that if you are putting, then see there is one knob is there, which with the help of that knob, we are arranging this whole scale as per our requirement of the angle. We require the 90 degree, then the angle is given at here. Okay, that is called as a protractor head. Okay, so near to the protractor head, the angle notation is given to us. So based on this protractor angle notation, we are arranged this scale as per our requirement of the angle. 45 degree, 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree, 67 degree, 75 degree, whatever the degree we require, we are arranged it in a very proper and accurate way. Okay, so on that time, very easy, knob is there. So we open it with the anti-clockwise and we fit it with the help of clockwise direction. So we are use the drafter, then no need to use the set square, but if you are use the T square, then we require the set square. Okay, so purchase the T square. On that time you just purchase the set square also. Okay, so it is called 30 degree. This is the set square where I put my cursor. This is known as a 30 degree, 60 degree set square, where from this line I can check the angle of 30 degree, and from this line I can measure the angle of 60 degree. While this is the 45 degree angle set square, where from both side I can check and I can measure and I can draw the angle of 45 degree. Okay. We know very well about this protractor. From any angle, from 0 to 180 degree, we are very easily check and measure and draw the angle, but it may require some time. Most probably we are use the angles of 30 degree, 60 degree and 45 degree. So probably very fastly with proper accuracy, we are draw the angles. That's why this set square are required. Already I arrange the mini drafter. Okay. And there is the wooden block. It is called as a drawing board. Okay. And the sheet is there, white sheet. You can see it here. जहाँ पे मुझे drawing करना. Okay. Now मैंने sheet रख दी है, लेकिन how I can fix it? To fixing the sheet, you just see it here in that four corner.
Your screen is not visible. Okay. Your screen is not visible.
1 minute.
Okay, now visible, I think. Okay, I repeat.
Sir, it is already visible.
Okay.
Yes, sir, already visited.
Okay, okay, don't worry. Now, see, मुझे मेरी एक drawing sheet है. Sheet means it's a one kind of page. So don't be confused and मैं next time पे आपको दिखाऊंगा exactly कि वो कैसे दिखती है and आपको sketchbook कैसे लानी है. Okay? So on that time we learn that के क्या करना है. लेकिन you just write down, assume that its thickness is not more than 2 or 3 mm. Okay? ऐसी एक sheet है, ऐसा एक page है, उसको मैंने यहाँ पे रखा है drawing board पे. क्यों? Because I want to draw some technical drawing. Now I want to fix it. मुझे उसको fix करना पड़ेगा. Okay? Because I want to draw something and with proper accuracy. That's why. So whatever I can use to fixing the page or sheet, it is called as a drawing pin. Okay? I just show you with separate figure. You can see it here with my cursor. कैसे रखनी है? That you can see it very easily. It's very very user friendly. So once you purchase it, then and you have drawing board, then it's easy for you to easily fixing with the board and with the page. Okay, so it may fixing the fix your page. Now your page is ready to draw. Okay, यहाँ पे एक और figure दी हुई है. It is called as a French cup. Wherever I just show you my cursor, it is called as a French curve, where it require mostly whenever I want to draw any awkward shapes. You can see it here, any kind of awkward shape which are not easily drawn with the help of freehand sketch. So on that time we have preferred this kind of French curve. Okay, if you are very good to drawing, on that time no need to purchase this kind of French curve. If you are not properly draw with the freehand sketch, so on that time we are preferred to use this kind of instrument or to draw the any complex shapes. Okay, that we require. In next to next lecture we have to start, or we will start our first chapter and to draw the different kind of reliefs. So on that time we require that kind of shapes. Okay, so you probably confident on yourself that you may draw properly ellipse or all the parabola or hyperbola, then no need to use the French curve. But you are not confident on yourself, then you just purchase it, purchase this accessory. Okay. Okay, now and these are some, I just talk about the drawing board, T square, mini drafter, set square. Okay, these are the basic 4 part. Now 5th part, protector, very important, and already you use it up to 12th, so no need to understand you that okay kaise use karna hai. But I want to say one thing, that the protector use at here is somewhat deeper. हमारे पास जो protector है वो और जो drawing में use होता है वो, there is some minor difference between that two. So I advise you to all that के purchase the protector which may help you to draw a simple 0 to 1 mm, or it means smallest dimension to the biggest dimension very easily and with proper accuracy. You are draw this, suppose I want to draw the circle of 2 mm diameter, so on that time it's not possible to draw with the help of our conventional protector. But if you are use the engineering protector, so on that time it's very easy and accurately you can draw the 2 mm diameter circle. So I just advise you that okay, you purchase the protector. Okay, now next thing, there are many books regarding the subject. Here I just show you one book, Andy Burt is there. Then same way PJ Shah is there. Same way PD Patel, Mahajan books is there. So many books are available. You can purchase any book or you may start to learn. Okay, and simultaneously we are just provide the material also. So right now no need to purchase any book. You just read all the fundamental with the help of material. So it's very easy for you. And concept definitely we clear one by one, and every week we just go through the funda initially, and after that 10 minutes regarding whatever we are covering in the previous lecture, and 5 minutes regarding what we want to do in this lecture, and then we have to start. Okay, so don't worry regarding the subject. I am sure ke this subject you may learn in very properly. If you have any query, then you may raise the query in Google Classroom or in the chat box, or you may directly unmute yourself and start to raise your query. Okay, so we definitely solve your query on that time.